I am today planning to go to Bugis Street. Yesterday I went to Bugis Junction, but today it's time for some street shopping. And yesterday I could not shop a lot because I was getting a hang of all the prices and, you know, the conversion going on in your head and everything. And always there is this thing back in your mind, what if you find something better? And so I decided, like, I'll go to Bugis Street today and explore that area well. Yesterday, because of Prasad, I could not do it properly. And yeah, I am going to travel alone today. Lisa is not with me, Prasad is not with me, so let's go.
So now I'm walking towards my station, Aljuneed. I don't want to try actually the bus or anything. So with the help of Google Maps, you can get anywhere, like exactly anywhere. Haan, thoda ghuma ghuma ke leke jata hai kabhi kabhi, but manageable hai. I should have not worn my heels today, I think so. Thoda sa troubling hai, or maybe because I've been in the comfort of my sports shoes since past few days, that's why. But if I find good footwear today, I'll buy surely. So a little change in plan. I thought I would go to Kwan Yin Temple before I head to Bugis Street. As Bugis Street is right at the MRT station, I think I will, now that I have a little energy left, I would cover up the other places around and then jump in here. But I found a McDonald's and I think I should not risk eating anything else today and just go to McDonald's and grab something. So let's go. So the whole meal costed me $7 and I think that's quite fair enough. $7 will be like around $350-$400 for a meal. I took a McSpicy meal. Okay, the menu, I didn't see anything in veg, it was everything non-veg. Chicken is there, beef is there, fillet of fish is the same, McSpicy chicken is the same, no halu tikki, no McVeggie. So yeah, since I'm a non-vegetarian, I am blessed, I will say. See, that is Kwan Yin Hu Temple. It is the oldest Buddhist temple in Singapore. Actually, photography wasn't allowed inside, so I had a look and their customs are really different to ours. I could not find anybody who could help me out understand why and what's about it, but that's all right. I really liked it. Inside, the interiors were like very nice, made of gold and red. And yeah, you can come here. No entry charges. Okay. And timings are morning 6 to 6:30 in the evening, except for some special days, lunar days, and there were many more, in which it's open till I think 7:30 or 8. Anyways, as I walked a little more ahead, I found this another Sri Krishnan temple. Okay, as I told you, Singapore is a mix of multicultural people around the world. So you saw there was a Buddhist temple and there's a Hindu temple too. So let's go, let's see. And again, it is a temple from the 18th century. It was built in 1870s. And again, one of the oldest temples in Singapore. So just going to explore the lanes around this Kwan Yin temple and see what's there. Actually, I can see a lot of souvenir shops. Thank you. according to Google Maps, I am on Ben Colleen Street, and there are a lot of good hotels and restaurants around me, like really cute and cool. I think I will later on, if I get time, I will come and sit around in one of the cafes. And if you see, the weather is changing, like, you know, in minutes. It's sometimes too sunny and sometimes it's nice shady. So you guys also know that I'm not a very big fan of museum and history. Actually, I never liked history, but I think little of it wouldn't harm my brains. So I'm planning to go to the museum right now. So let's go. Again, it's a walk. I'm using Google Maps, which is helping me go around. And yeah, thank you, Google Maps. The National Museum is supposed to be the oldest museum of Singapore, built in 1849. So I took my tickets. It costed me like $1.15, and he told me to proceed to level 2 and then come down to level 1. So let's go. I am now quite excited. So this gallery is taking up a lot of time. You need a lot of patience, okay? Now I'm going to Glass Rotunda. I don't know what it is exactly. My happy place. There's nobody, and I think I can set my camera and get one shot at least. I must say, I am speechless. These paintings are made by primary school kids, and they are so incredible. I must give you a closer view too. They're so good, vibrant, and beautiful. Like, I don't mind hanging it in my like drawing room, or like, it's such, I'm speechless. I feel so good. It's all vibrant colors, and you know, Singapore depicted in one picture. I love it. I totally love it. Guys, if you're watching this, I want to tell you, you've done a great job. A souvenir shop and a cafe behind there. You can, if you are hungry, yeah, you will be end of this tour, so you will need something to eat for sure. Almost 6:05, 6:10, and I almost took like 2 hours without stopping at each section. So you see, 2 hours agar fatafat chale to ho jayega, or else you might take longer. So if you want to spend like a full-fledged time and you have a lot of time, you can come here. Actually, when I had come to Singapore before, I did not like go around these places. Like I had not come to the National Museum because of time constraints, because usually Singapore tour is like 3 days or maximum 4 days, out of which 1 day goes in Universal Studio, then the second day goes in the zoo and everything. So if you are staying for a longer time, you should come here because the museum tells you about the full history A to Z about Singapore's history, and from clothes to their tea set to everything. Then there are exhibitions put up, various exhibitions, out of which today was for the primary school kids, and they had depicted Singapore in such a wholesome manner. I totally loved it. And now I'm heading towards another extension. There is this Gallery 10. I don't know what it is exactly, so let's go. I tried and managed to click a few pictures. Now let's see if they've come out good. And if you want to check them out, go follow me on Instagram. My Instagram ID is here, Dr. Biofiles. So do not miss out on those self-clicked portraits. Oh, now I'm walking back to Bugis. Google Maps shows 10 minutes of walk. I wonder if it is 10 minutes. And my battery is low. Let's hope I reach there and I'm able to shoot something. Okay, see you. Albert Street, and opposite that is the Bugis Street. See here? So now my battery is actually low. It's like 20%. I don't know how am I going to survive. And using Google Maps, my portable is also almost half dead. Now let's go. I bought a hat from Albert Market for like $10, and I think it was fair enough because yesterday in Bugis Junction we saw many hats and they were like $27 and $30, so I think this is like fair enough. I don't know if I'm going to wear it because those are like sort of beach caps and this is such a city place. So let's go to Bugis. Skirt which was like similar, so it was like an offer, buy 2 for $25, so we bought it together. And yeah, and we're gonna wear the same skirt sometime.
Yeah, but mine is too stretched. Hers not.
No. Thank you. Bye. Bugis is like Shopper's Paradise, but I am tired. Actually, a lot of walking, and I wore the wrong footwear. So again, I would like to precise on that. Wear shoes. And now I'm just going home, like going to Bugis Junction and then back home. And I really like Bugis for the variety and the quality of clothes that they have. It's better than Mumbai street shopping, I would say.
Yeah.
So let's go to the MRT and get back home.